Hello, 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 guys. It's Natasha Talk Truth. We don't do nothing but speak the truth all day, every day. So let's get into it. Hello, 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 guys. How everybody doing? I hope everybody having a wonderful, wonderful day. If you're not, just know, get on your knees and pray, because prayer still works. All righty, guys. My smoke detectors are beeping crazy in the back, all right? Jesus. So I wanted to put out some information that's disturbing. Very disturbing, okay? I am still working on these receipts, guys, so just give me a day and I will be uploading that video. But I wanted to put this out because this is crucial, you know. And I don't think that we speak on it or play it enough, okay? Now, everybody knows, even the alleged victim Kemp knows by this time that this woman is a liar and she's lying, okay? I gotta say allegedly, but based on her own words, yeah, she is a liar, okay? Now, this is disturbing. When I hear this, I cringe because I know that Kenny was innocent and this woman, This deranged teenager at the time, habitual liar, troubled teenager, okay, lied and sent an innocent kid to prison because Kenny didn't want her, because Kenny didn't choose her, okay? Kenny didn't get a fair trial. We know that. I mean, we all know that who study and did research about our communities, what happened in our communities with our fathers, brothers. We know what happened. You're not going to get a fair trial. And then when I hear people say, oh, she wasn't a white woman, well, she was a mixed race woman, and here's a black male. Come on now. So let me say this. What y'all gonna hear in this video? And people have already heard it before. Most people have heard it before. But they haven't heard it the way I'm going to break it down, the way I'm getting ready to play it, because I think this is very critical to Kenny's innocence. Daytime tea time, to me, in my opinion, she knows Jennifer is not being truthful. She knows. That's why those videos were taken down at first. She heard the inconsistencies in Jennifer's story. Jennifer told her story first to Daytime Tea Time. And I know she heard Jennifer sitting on these platforms and changing up her story about who took her to drop the charges or recant.
We weren't allowed to have a voice back then. So anything I said went right out the window. It was like Miss Robinson, that was my grandmother, it was like she almost believed them, because it was easier to believe them than to believe what really happened.
Wow.
His mother and father, those, the people I lived with, they allowed his mother and father to take me to go see the district attorney to pretend like they were my aunt and my uncle.
Pretend like what?
Pretend like they were my aunt and uncle.
Oh, wow.
So if we were in a relationship, if this was because my mother, you know, didn't like the fact that we was in a relationship, whatever story they told or trying to tell, he wouldn't have been arrested and he wouldn't have done 4 years. He wouldn't have been able to plead out to something other than what he originally, you know what I'm saying? Like, it wouldn't have been such an open and shut case if that was the case.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
so who was going to pretend to be the aunt and uncle?
His mother and father.
Oh, wow. Just to have, like, you know, parents there.
So they could go back and, I guess, let his lawyer know what was going on. Like, they didn't come in there with me and say, we're Kenneth Petty's parents. Let me explain something to you. They tried to force me to drop the charges. They were hiding me on the steps in the courthouse. The state took the case over because, you know, of my age. So it wasn't Jennifer against Kenneth Petty. It was the state of New York City against Kenneth Petty. So I didn't have to be at court to testify. They weren't using me to testify.
Okay.
There was no reason for me to be at court. They forced me to go to the courthouse to drop the charges. I was hiding on a staircase. If it just so happened that something was going on with the elevator, or maybe it was taking too long or whatever, but the DA happened to come up the steps and she seen me and she pulled me aside and asked me what was I doing here, and I was able to whisper to her that they were trying to force me to drop the charges. And she reassured me that it wasn't gonna happen. I still went into the courtroom, and when the judge asked, does anybody have anything to say, I stood up and said, I want to drop the charges. But the DA had already spoken to whoever she's spoken to, and the judge was like, no, take it to the DA. And
oh, because they knew that you were being forced.
Right, exactly.
Okay. Now, Jennifer comes on the platform in 2020 with these stories. She forgot about the big lie that she told. And I just think Jennifer forgot what she told Daytime about who took her to drop the charges. A recant, okay? So Jennifer sits on these platforms and she speaks and she said her aunt and uncle took her to drop the charges. Or we can't.
Well, let me explain to y'all what happened, you know, as far as the dropping the charges thing goes. So the state had already had it was always the state of New York against Kenneth Petty. The state picked the case up right away. It was never me against him. It was always the state. What happened was, because the state picked the case up, there was no reason for me to go to court. Because, you know, I had already went to the hospital. I had already did the rape kit. They had already found the evidence that I told him that he used against me, which was the knife. They walked out the house with him and the knife in a bag. You know what I'm saying? So I felt like I'm guessing that they already had all the evidence that they needed. What happened was, I had an older family member in my family who took me to court on his court date. And they had me on the stairwell. Mind you, I wasn't supposed to be in court. I didn't have to testify. I didn't have to go, you know, on the stand. I didn't have to do any of that because the cases, you know, the state had already picked it up. So I'm standing on the stairwell, waiting for his court time, waiting for him to go to court, because I was supposed to stand up in court and say, I want to drop the charges, you know, in that kind of a way. But what happened was the district attorney wound up taking the steps. Nothing but God. She took the steps. And when she seen me, she asked me, Jennifer, what are you doing here? You're not supposed to be here. You don't have to be here for this. And I was able to turn my back to the people I was with and let her know that they were trying to force me to drop the charges. So I did follow through with going in the courtroom. I did stand up. I did interrupt the judge. And I said, I want to drop the charges. Those are the only words that came out of my mouth. I never said I lied about what happened. I never said that you know, he didn't do what I said he did. All I said was I wanted to drop the charges. But because I had already told the district attorney what they were trying to make me do when I got in the courtroom, they wasn't trying to hear it. That's the truth.
Y'all gonna hear the same story, but two different people, okay? Jennifer is going to, and hi shit, this is for you. This is for you because you love to when people bring this up, you love to go off on people and say, this was two different occasions. Stop listening to them barbs. Stop trying to twist stuff up. But you know the truth. You know the truth. You know that this woman is lying. And you know that these stories don't make sense. You know that. So, you're going to hear her speak about who took her to recount her stories. What's disturbing is, in one of these videos, clips, what's disturbing is, Jennifer gets upset because they you know, in her, that she thinks that they're not believing her. So she gets upset because she's watching the comments, okay? And in this video, they were doing another interview after she done told all these stories on these different platforms. To me, they grouped up. This is when everything, you know, I think the plan was laid out. You know, and I believe that at this point, Hotshot knew that the plan and knew that Jennifer was after Nicki Minaj's money. They bring her back up and say she's going to address some of the questions because nothing made sense. She talked about, like I said, who took her to drop the charges. You're going to hear Jennifer, okay, tell this story because she's mad because the question came up again. Y'all going to hear this woman in detail how, what happened. She's going to clarify the different days that she, that her aunt and uncle and Kenny's parents took her to drop the charges and recant. Okay? You're also going to hear Jennifer say the DA told her she wasn't supposed to be there. But you're going to hear Jennifer say she was going to see the DA to talk about some things. This was, you know, with every other inconsistency and lie she has told, this one here really stuck with me. It really stuck with me and rubbed me the wrong way. And I knew in my heart when I heard this BS that this boy never, or that woman.
Question, Nosy, but this is before it slips my mind because somebody made a real crazy statement on one of my comments. They said that, why did you say you went to the court with your cousin first and then you said you went with Kenneth Petty's parents? I said in response to that that I believe.
No. Listen, what I said was, right? What I said was, Kenneth's mother and father came to pick me up from my house and drove me to go speak to the district attorney, right? That's what I said about Kenneth Petty's parents. That's the only thing I said about Kenneth Petty's parents, is that they came to my house. I had to get in the back seat of their vehicle, drive with them to the city to go see. Now, I was supposed to be going to see the district attorney for myself to speak with her about, you know, whatever was going on. Well, Kenneth Petty's mother and father came with me and pretended like they were my aunt and my uncle.
Okay. Was your cousin present at that time?
No. Okay. It was just me, Kenneth Petty, and whatever. Listen, whatever Sunday Grayson stated were lies.
Right.
They were lies. Nobody took me to the hospital. Nobody went out looking for anything. The police took me to the hospital. Mm-hmm. My aunt is the one who took me to court to drop the charges. Two totally different separate occasions.
Right. Thank you.
That wasn't the same day. That wasn't the same occasion. That was two separate occasions.
Exactly.
The aunt took you to drop the charges because of the threats?
Right, because of the threats being made towards the house.
Corey admitted that he threatened your family on Kenneth Petty's behalf.
Right.
Jen, did you turn your camera off because you have anxiety about the people in the comments? That's fine if that's why.
Yeah, it's a lot. I just see my face up there longer than,
yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I'm me. I'm still me. You know, I showed my face, but it's a lot.
You're still getting your courage and your strength back, so we understand.
I just know they're going to try to use that against you, but, mm-hmm. you know, people have a right to have anxiety about something like that. That's why I wanted to address it, because I know they're going to try to use that against
you.
I mean, I'm still here. I'm still the same person. It's not like, you know, we switch faces or somebody else is speaking for me. I'm still here. I just don't feel like I have to sit.
These barbs are crazy. They will say that you're a different person.
They've already called me a liar.
We weren't allowed to have a voice back then. So anything I said went right out the window. It was like Miss Robinson, that was my grandmother, it was like she almost believed them. Because it was easier to believe them than to believe what really happened.
Wow.
His mother and father, the people I lived with, they allowed his mother and father to take me to go see the district attorney to pretend like they were my aunt and my uncle.
Pretend like what?
Pretend like they were my aunt and uncle.
Oh, wow.
So, if we were in a relationship, if this was because my mother, you know, didn't like the fact that we was in a relationship, whatever story they told or trying to tell, he wouldn't have been arrested and he wouldn't have done 4 years. He wouldn't have been able to plead out to something other than what he originally, you know what I'm saying? Like, it wouldn't have been such an open and shut case if that was the case.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
so who was going to pretend to be the aunt and uncle?
His mother and father.
Oh, wow. Just to have, like, you know, parents there.
So they could go back and, I guess, let his lawyer know what was going on. Like, they didn't come in there with me and say, we're Kenneth Petty's parents. Let me explain something to you. They tried to force me to drop the charges. They were hiding me on the steps in the courthouse. The state took the case over because, you know, of my age. So it wasn't Jennifer against Kenneth Petty. It was the state of New York City against Kenneth Petty. So I didn't have to be at court to testify. They weren't using me to testify.
Okay.
There was no reason for me to be at court.
Why? I believe, this is my opinion. I believe that Jennifer involved Kenny's parents and told this big fat lie that her parents allowed Kenny's parents to take her to drop the charges or recant. Same thing, same difference. While they try to, you know, twist it. Because Tasha K. There were words of Tasha K allegedly spoken to Kenny's parents and was going to do an interview and come forward and speak about what really went down. The involvement of Jennifer.
So I could care less who he's with. If he would have registered, nobody would be hearing from me right now.
Right.
That you know, because that T-blog interview, that went under the radar. That didn't go anywhere. That didn't escalate. Other people wasn't talking about it. Tasha K spoke about it a little bit, and the way she talked was like she spoke to the family and they too said we was in a relationship and they were gonna come forward. Well, the only people who can come forward to speak anything about me would be his mother and father. Mm-hmm. Because those are the only two people that had encounter with me at the time that he was going to court. Because like I said, my family allowed his mother and his father. Could you imagine sitting in the back seat of the parents whose son just totally violated you?
Right.
That's the kind of stuff that I had to deal with.
I've always thought about not being here. But I never thought about the actual act. And that's all I could think about when I see those text messages today. And to hear that his family is willing to come forward and just lie, like this didn't really happen. And
I know
that's not fair. It's not.
Nobody from the neighborhood could come and say Jennifer was a slut back in the day, or Jennifer was sleeping with this nigga and sleeping with that nigga.
Well, honestly, that's actually the issue that made me contact your aunt today, because that's actually what they are saying happened. You know, they're gonna go with the storylines. You know, I'm just, you know, paraphrasing, but something along the lines of that you and Kenny were in a relationship, you guys would have sex often, he was abusive towards you and would make you have sex with his homeboys, and you would do whatever he told you to do, just like any other girl. Like if Kenny had a girl and he told her to have sex with his homeboy, the girl would do it. So that's what I'm being told is going to be coming out soon. So I wanted to get your side of it.
I don't understand how that can make him look any better.
Yeah, I agree. I don't think it's meant to make him look good. I think that, you know, that's their side of the story, and they're saying that, you know, you were in a relationship with him. I think that's the point they're trying to get across, that you weren't just some girl he grabbed off the corner.
So that's the reason why I believe that she told this lie, that her parents allowed Kenny's parents to take her to the, you know, kind of throw them under the bus. So when it does come out, when this story does come out, because she was worried. She was so worried about Kenny's parents telling the truth on her ass. She was worried. To where she said, oh, you, to me, I'm going to throw their ass under the bus first. That she was worried that people were going to tell, you know, what really happened, what really was going on, that she was a young slut, hoe, and was messing around with the boys, allegedly getting that choo-choo ran on her. Mm-hmm. Because it made no sense. How can Kenny's parents pretend to be your aunt and uncle? I know Candace sat up there and said, girl, that don't even make sense. How? Who's Kenny's parents? Who's his parents? So in this video, y'all gonna hear this woman, okay? This woman adamant. She's telling lies. I mean, she's adamant about this. I mean, adamant. Not one time, not two times, not three times, maybe four times that she told this story on different platforms about Kenny's parents pretending to be her aunt and uncle. And she was in the back seat. And they took her down there to drop the charges. Bitch, you sent an innocent child to prison because he didn't choose your ass. I'm angry. This is wrong. And then you got the audacity to try to extort them? Let me bring it down. The conspiracy. These people conspiring on Nicki Minaj and Kenny is sick. And y'all ass is going to hell. Y'all ass is going to burn. Y'all gonna burn in hell. I hope y'all know that. How shit I know? I hope you know that you're going to burn in hell. Cardi B's gonna burn in hell. Queen K's gonna burn in hell. Jennifer is going to burn in hell. All y'all are going to burn in hell for what y'all have done and created on two innocent people that have done anything. Don't be trying to make Nicki Minaj look bad because y'all fave, you know, jumped on the internet and called and did all this, embarrassed herself, taking shits on IG Live. Doing all this stuff, and y'all want to tarnish Nicki Minaj's career to try to make her look as bad as old girl? Don't try it. Don't try it, because hashtag surviving Cardi B will always be there. Her saying that she drugged and robbed men will always be there. Her calling a dead baby a monkey will always be there. It will always be there. Sick son of a bitches. All right, guys, y'all let me know what y'all think in the comment section, and I got to go because I got to finish up. I love all of y'all, and thank you guys for my new subscribers. Thank you, Black T Block, for giving me a shout out and bringing awareness to my video. And thank Crystal Nicole, because she plays a big part in you know, this the case. You know, I have to give both of those ladies, you know, their props, because I always stated if it wasn't for them, it would be some problems, okay? And thank you, you know, to just everybody who is on the right side and love Nicki Minaj and knows that this is wrong and know that this play victim. I ain't calling her no alleged victim. This extortion victim is being dishonest and sent an innocent child to prison because he didn't choose her, not the other way around. Bye bye. Mwah. Queen K, as we all know, Cardi B's good friend, and that's no allegedly. It's admitted that she's the one who kicked this off. Okay. Jennifer act like she don't know who sent it. She act like she don't know who sent it. It just happened. You're going to hear Hot Shot. I'm going to play it again. You're going to hear him throw bombs and say thank you and clap for getting it started. But then you're going to hear Jennifer lie. She don't know how the sealed documents got in the hands of one of Cardi B's good friends. Then this bitch had the nerve to have a breakdown and fucking cry. Girl, you know what? You know what? God is gonna whoop. Girl, your karma. Your karma. Your karma. This is crazy. This is crazy. Now, I don't want to make this video too long because I got to get back and finish up these receipts, okay? But I definitely wanted to put this out. I definitely wanted to put this out. This bothered me so much. This is wrong. And Candace from Daytime Tea Time, I can't tell you what to do, but I did notice that you were coming back. I mean, you surrounded by, you know, the church, okay? You should come up on your platform and speak, because you know that this woman told lies. So if you find it in your heart to just come and clear up or just speak about the inconsistencies that she told on your channel. You know, all these bloggers, you know, they claim that they, you know, that they real, and if they made a mistake, that they would, you know, take accountability and, you know, and come to their platform and speak about it. So this is not a challenge, but I'm just saying, you know, y'all so real, stick to your word. You know, because this makes Candace look bad because she has not spoke about it. And she took those videos down at first because she knew that those inconsistency stories that she told about who took her to the court. I mean, hey, I'm just going by what they. I mean, everybody run around here and say I'm so real and I take accountability and I'll do this and I'll do that. Well, come on with that accountability. Come on, load that camera up, honey. This is sad. Like, it's sad because Kenny was falsely accused, spent time in jail, never. Okay, put it like this. If, let's say he did this, you do know that most offenders repeat nothing at all. And Redbone, no, I got some questions for her. I do. See, she was under the reel giving Jennifer the strong arm. So I asked her a question that made her give a response on Instagram. Oh, I asked that question, and that's when she gave that response on Instagram, because the way I asked the question, it boxed her in, and she get up there and she lies, say she didn't know. Girl, yes.